Hey, what's going on? Zach Crawford here. And in this video, I'm going to teach you how to get started with affiliate marketing, regardless if you have a budget or you basically have no budget to start at all. So if you are somebody who, let's say, is broke, you don't have any money, I'm going to share a few examples with you how you can get started for free. If you are somebody who has, say, $100 to $200 to invest a little bit to speed up the process, I'm going to share a few tips with you there. And if you're somebody that has money, you're not somebody who wants to, you know, basically do everything for free and do everything on the cheap, I'm going to share a few resources with you to help you fast track your results. Now, if you're new to the channel, most of my videos are specialized, or I should say focused, on affiliate marketing, creating passive income, and basically entrepreneurship. If that's not of value to you, that's not something you really care about, this video is probably not going to be of interest to you. Now, every single day, I literally publish videos on affiliate marketing, tips, case studies of what I'm doing in my business, case studies of what my coaching students are doing. And literally, if you want to do a deep dive on how to get into affiliate marketing and literally how to learn every aspect of it, I'll be covering it on this channel. With that being said, I don't want to assume that you know what affiliate marketing is or you completely understand it, because maybe you found my video from somebody else's video. So what I want to do is I want to explain to you in a way that pretty much anybody can get it, right? So basically what affiliate marketing is it's the process of recommending somebody else's product and then you get paid. So here's the easiest example I can explain to you. So this camera right here, I probably dropped somewhere around $2,500 with the whole setup, with like the mic and the screen that goes on the top, the lens and the whole shebang. So basically what I did is I got on YouTube. I was watching a ton of different reviews and trying to figure out what camera will actually do the things that I need. So basically the camera I'm shooting on right now, like when it's cranked up, I'm only shooting on 1/4 of the quality. The quality is just amazing. It's phenomenal and it does what I need it to do. When I'm just sitting still like this, the camera is awesome. When I'm moving around and say, like, once again, I have the camera and I'm vlogging, right? If I'm walking around or I'm moving like this, and it just struggles to capture my face. It literally will make you nauseous trying to watch it. Compared to this camera, it's amazing for that. Like, it will just keep me in focus no matter what I do. It will drown out the background and it never struggles. And that's what I was looking for, right? So when I was on YouTube, I basically went through a bunch of people trying to figure out, like, who's gonna show me which camera is what I need. Well, when you go on YouTube, a lot of the people are just trying to recommend anything they can to get an affiliate commission. We'll talk about this later. But basically, I ended up buying through this guy because he broke down the pros and the cons. And he seemed very trustworthy. He was very genuine. He wasn't trying to hype everything up and make it seem like it was the world's best camera when we all know that every camera has its flaws. And so that's why I bought from him. And because of the fact that I dropped $2,500 plus, he got a nice commission because I bought it through Amazon. I bought literally the batteries, all the accessories are recommended, everything he said I needed, I just ordered it all in one go, because I'm the kind of person that my time is money. I don't want to spend, you know, wasting researching 1,000 videos. I just went with what he said because I watch his YouTube channel, he's built a brand, and I actually trust him. So that is the easiest way to understand affiliate marketing, right? He didn't have to create the product. He doesn't have to deal with the customer service. So let's say that, you know, for whatever reason, I don't like that screen, it sucks. Like, Amazon is the one that has to deal with that, not him. That's one of the great things about affiliate marketing, is you don't have to create any products. You can find products in every single industry, literally. You don't have to deal with the customers, so no refund complaints, no where's my product, it hasn't got here yet, no random silly questions. And what's great about it is you don't got to be, you know, an amazing salesman or saleswoman in order to get started. Now, with that being said, master sales. Sales will change your life. But you can get started by just being a nice person and recommending products that you like. It's literally that simple. Now, programs like, let's say, Best Buy, Walmart, Travelocity, these are all big places that have affiliate programs. Another place that I really like is called 𝐖𝐡𝐞𝐧. Maybe you've seen the commercials on TV if you're in the United States. Basically, what you do is you install a plugin on your browser, whether that be like Chrome or Firefox. You go to, say, bestbuy.com, you're going to have a pop-up that tells you, hey, you can get 5% cash back by, you know, buying this product right now. Basically, what 𝐖𝐡𝐞𝐧 is, they are like me. They are like you. They are an affiliate. They just created a massive database, and anywhere you go, they are members for affiliate programs, and they're just sharing their affiliate commission for you. So, for instance, they're giving you 5% cash back on it. They're probably getting somewhere like, say, a 30% commission. All they're doing is they're sharing that affiliate commission with you, and they're making millions upon millions of dollars every single month. Affiliate marketing is a massive industry. It's literally a massive industry in pretty much every industry you can find. And the reality is you've probably been exposed to affiliate marketing already, even if you don't even quite understand it. Let's say you follow somebody big on social media, like an influencer, right? If they recommended you off of, say, Instagram to a website, to a clothing company, to, you know, a physical product, to buy a gadget or something like that, The reality is you probably are buying through their affiliate links, or even if you didn't buy, they're sending you to somewhere through their affiliate link, and whoever purchases, they get paid. Literally, people make thousands of dollars every single day, just like I do with affiliate marketing. You know, at this point, I've made over 7 figures online with affiliate marketing. And the reason I love it so much and recommend it to everybody to get started is because it's the easiest business model with the lowest overhead, which is one of the other great points about it, is that you don't need a bajillion dollars to get started. Most business models, you're going to need $2,000 to $3,000 just to get started, plus ongoing expenses. Now, as I said, I'm going to share all different budgets on this channel, and I do suggest that you invest money, because if you actually treat this like a real business and not just like a toy or a hobby or something you're doing hoping you're going to get rich quick, you can make very, very obscene amounts of money rather quickly. Now, with that being said, I want to cover to show you the potential of how big affiliate marketing is, because people will say silly things like, oh, it's saturated. You should have got in 10 years ago when it got started. Of course, it was stupid, silly to easy money back then. Like, I didn't even get in at like the heyday. Like, probably I started around 6 years ago, and like I heard stories about how like people would spend like a penny on Google for traffic and they would just make back crap tons of money. Now that's not gonna happen. Like, the waters are more bloody, there is more competition. Well, it's like anything, if there's a lot of money to be made, there's gonna be competition. You shouldn't fear competition. You should look at it like, hey, if people are making money there, I'm gonna get a share of that. So affiliate marketing over the next 5 years is projected to grow by $6.8 billion. So I think it's safe to say it's not saturated, and I think it's safe to say that you should jump in now, because at the end of the day, there's gonna be plenty of money to be made. And the question is, are you gonna be one of the people to make the money? All right, so let's jump into the actual part of this video where I actually share with you how you can get started with affiliate marketing depending on your budget. So I'm going to share whether you have $0 to get involved. So say you're broke, you just don't have much funding, so to speak, to get started in a business. If you have at least $100 to get started, and if you have more of a bigger budget, an ongoing budget, maybe you have a good job and you want to speed the process up. Now, before I jump into that, I want to say subscribe to this channel if you like this video so far. I publish videos like this every single day, and comment below it and let me know if there's something you want me to cover, a specific video on a topic that you want me to cover, throw it below. It's going to make my life easier for creating content to give you exactly what you want. With that being said, I want to talk about first the first category, which is the $0 budget. Now, before I jump into that, I want to talk about why you want to get out of this mentality as fast as possible. People that try to do things for free, they oftentimes like struggle, and a lot of times they never get to where they want to be. With what I'm going to teach you with the $0 method, you literally can get to $100 a day, but most people will never get there, and the reason being is they'll quit well before that happens. You know, I'm not going to sit here and sugarcoat you and BS you like a lot of people on YouTube. You know, at the end of the day, like, you got to work hard. There's no way around it. When people tell you things are going to be easy, you should just run, because it's just a bold-faced lie. So at the end of the day, when you stay in this $0 category, right, you don't want to invest any money, you want to do everything for free, it's going to prolong your success. And I realize some people, they just don't have money, right? I started $50,000 in debt. I got hit by a drunk driver. So when I got into this industry, mine was all out of desperation. I just wanted to get the hell out of my situation, change my life, and just be able to have a little money left over. My goal was not to become some millionaire. That was not what I set out to do. Now, with that being said, when you stay in this category where you're not trying to invest any money, you're trying to do everything for free, if you don't get results sooner than later, you're probably going to quit. The longer you go by not producing results, you're going to start saying, man, this doesn't work, and I knew this was a scam, and you're going to become very jaded that like the business is not worth building. The faster you get to the point where you can invest money in your business, it's going to allow you to fast track your success. It's going to make what you're doing easier. It's going to help automate the process. At the end of the day, nobody's goal when they get online to start a business is to grind 24/7. For some people, maybe I'm kind of one of those oddball types that I just love business. And honestly, I'd rather be doing business than a lot of what most people consider fun. But I'm probably in that rare category that loves the hustle, right? Most people want freedom. They want to be able to build a business that doesn't require them to work 24/7, and they want to call their own shots. So if you want to do that, get to the category where you can invest money in your business much quicker. It's going to speed up the process. Now, how do you make money if you have no money to invest, right? The easiest thing to do is create a YouTube channel. And I know right now a lot of people are like, nope, not doing it. And trust me, I get it. When I first started, I don't know if you can see the guy with like the snowboarding like thing back there. That was my original mentor, and he made me do videos. I wanted no part of videos. Like, it just scared the hell out of me. It terrified me to think people could judge me. Like, if you can see right here, I'm literally covered in tattoos all over my body. So I figured naturally people are going to tear me down. They're going to think that I look like some criminal. They're going to say mean things. And back then, I was not the confident person I am now. Somebody could call me a scammer. Somebody could make fun of me. Somebody could say mean things, and I'm just going to laugh at them because it just reflects who they are. But back then, somebody could say like something that was just mildly mean, and I literally want to quit what I was doing, right? I was not confident like that. And so what I did every single day, I'd pick up the camera and go, and that was about as much as I could get out. I could make like a little bit of a crazy squeaky noise, and I couldn't even say a word. I was just so intensely terrified to think about like what's going to happen when I upload this video. I don't know why I was that scared, but I've met a lot of people that have that same feeling. If you're one of the people that like, all I got to do is shoot videos, then I admire you, because very few people are like that. Most people, the thought of publishing content online is just terrifying. So it took me 30 days to do this. Every single day, I picked up my phone and tried to do it. I even got drunk one night, still didn't happen. And eventually I was just like, you know what? I'm not going to be a little snowflake. I'm not going to sit and let fear stop me. So every single day I picked up the phone until I was able to get over that fear, shoot my first video. And then I uploaded two or three videos, and people started asking me when I'm going to shoot my next video. And I'm like, really? I was so terrified about this. And this is like, this is, people want to hear what I have to say. What was funny though, is even when I was shooting the content, I was very stiff. I'd be like, hi guys, this is Zach Crawford, and I'm going to teach you about, like, and I would a lot of times look off to the side, and I'd kind of like look down, because in the beginning, I'm going to tell you, it's very weird when you're looking into a camera lens and it's not a real person, and you're like, man, I look so stupid, I feel so dumb, and you have to get over that fear. Once you get over it, like, it's not a big deal, it really isn't, and it's the best way, hands down, to make a living online. Honestly, if you do what I'm sharing with you here, you can easily get to $100 a day. So what you do is you go sign up for Amazon Associates. It's probably the easiest program to get signed up for. Honestly, I don't really do a whole lot of Amazon Associates anymore. I like private affiliate programs. You can get paid much higher commissions. And at the end of the day, I don't like selling cheap stuff. But if you're just getting started, beggars can't be choosers, right? And it's probably one of the most trusted affiliate programs, because Amazon is the biggest place to buy stuff. So as I shared with you before, like when I went to go buy this camera, right, I bought through Amazon through somebody who recommended the product. So it's one of those places when somebody recommends you to it, you don't question like, is this a safe place to do business? You know, some people are skeptical where they spend their money, and that's the beauty of Amazon. So when you get started, you can literally go find products you like. And at the end of the day, you don't even need to own it. It could just be something you're reviewing or something you're sharing and you're linking to it. Like there's literally bajillions of products on Amazon. You can find something in every single category. What I would suggest is probably try to stay in one niche. And by niche, I mean like a specific category, things people are passionate about. Like example, if you look like, you know, tech YouTubers, they literally review, you know, gadgets all the time. Now, that's not really realistic for the average person, because not everybody has money to go buy new gadgets all the time. And obviously, you wouldn't be able to do that category if you're in the $0 category. With that being said, there's a million different things you can find on Amazon if you have something you're passionate about, something that you like, that you can create videos and recommend them. If you go do a little bit of research, you know, I create videos on this channel teaching how to research industries. You know, you can find an industry that you can dominate and literally just create videos, tutorials, and recommend products. If you do that and you consistently publish, there's no reason you shouldn't be able to get to $100 a day. With that being said, don't expect to publish three videos and you're going to get rich. It's just, it's not going to happen, right? You're going to have to consistently publish. Honestly, I suggest publishing every single day. If you can't publish every single day, publish as often as you can, because consistency is the key no matter what you do. Now, once you get to $100 a day, I highly suggest you move on to method number two, because this is going to speed up the process and that's going to get you to the six-figure mark. All right, so method number two is going to require you to have at least $100. You know, you can do it slightly cheaper, but honestly, you need about $100. Now, with that being said, if you can skip method number one, you can come up with $100. Like, honestly, even if you're a teenager, I'm pretty sure if you ask your parents, you probably can get the money to do this. It's going to allow you to build a real business. This method alone can get you to like the six-figure mark if you're really consistent, you work hard, and you treat this like a real business, right? You're not treating it like a toy. This is going to allow you to scale to even bigger numbers when you combined it with method number three, which I'll share with you later. You know, method number two, which is what I'm talking about now, and method number three combined got me to over $500,000 with 100% free traffic. So I'm pretty confident you can at least do six figures if you treat it seriously in just about any niche industry. So what we're talking about is building an authority website. This means you're actually going to treat this like a real business. You're not just focused on getting one-time sales and just doing the bare minimum possible. You're building a real asset. The reason I like, you know, creating a website, right? You're creating organic traffic, which this is what people talk about, real passive income, right? What you're doing is you're creating articles. Google's going to send you free traffic, which is going to get you sales every single day. So you, yes, have to put your time up front, but once you do it, it consistently keeps sending you money. When I first started doing this, I started writing articles around everything in my niche, and literally I started seeing sales every single day. Now, I moved to method number 3, which was much smarter and allowed me to make 10 times more money, but if you just do this, it's going to allow you to speed up your income, it's going to allow you to build a real asset and a personal brand. You know, I talked about earlier where, for instance, I bought the camera, right? And it was because the person built a brand. They have a website. When they actually link to their stuff, maybe they do a YouTube video like this, but when they link to their blog, it goes even more detail on the actual product. It gives examples, it references other articles, which makes me trust the person 10 times more because they're not just somebody throwing up a video and putting in very little effort. So in my opinion, without having a website, you're really screwing yourself as far as a long-term business, a long-term asset. If you're gonna create the content, you may as well go the extra step and build something that's going to be an evergreen asset that keeps sending you money. Now, here's the second reason why you absolutely want a website. Most affiliate programs will not approve you without a website. You know, years ago, I was promoting Netflix. I'm not sure if they're still allowing people to do that, unless you're probably a high-tier affiliate. But back then, when I tried to apply for Netflix to promote it, they wouldn't allow me to do it in the beginning because I didn't have a website. So what I had to do, I had to go figure out how to build a website. You know, literally, you can do it in 10 minutes. You can literally set up a website by clicking a few buttons, and that's it. It's very, very simple. And I set up a website and I got approved. So networks like, say, ClickBank, Commission Junction, you know, any of the private affiliate networks, if you don't have a website that they can kind of look at and see that you're actually making an effort to actually build a community, build an audience, and send them legit leads, they won't approve you. And that's what most affiliate networks are looking for. They're looking for people that are actually treating this like a real business, and they're gonna send them qualified leads that will turn into sales for their business. They don't want somebody who's just trying to cut corners and make a quick buck, because a lot of times those people will just do shady things. They'll literally spam their offers all over the internet, which misrepresents the brand or the product owner's, you know, brand that they've spent time building. So if you wanna get approved for the higher tier programs that you can make, you know, $100, $200, $500 plus per sell, you're gonna need a website, hands down. They're just not gonna let you in. And for me personally, I don't really promote a lot of stuff on Amazon. It's a great beginner network because it's something that anybody can set up and get going in any industry. You know, I recommend books and I recommend cameras and the things that I use, but I don't depend on that as my main source of income. You would need to make hundreds of sales, if not thousands of sales, to equal the same thing you can get just a handful of sales by promoting more expensive products. And trust me, there's plenty of people out there buying expensive stuff. Now, that is method number 2. What you want to do if you want to scale bigger is combine that with method number 3, which I'm about to share with you now. All right, so method number 3 is literally used by the biggest brands online, the biggest marketers online, whether we're talking the make money online niche, we're talking about the fitness niche, the dating niche, anywhere lots of money is to be made. And it's even the method that the President Obama used to win the election. Now, I'm not into politics. Honestly, I don't care who's in office. But the point being is this is the smartest thing you can do for your business. What we're talking about is building an email list. For whatever reason, affiliate marketers just don't want to do this. Like, it's like they're burning money. I just don't get it why they refuse to do it, but they're costing themselves a lot of money. Most affiliate marketers build their business just the way Shopify people build their business, the way people that are in Amazon build their business. And all they're doing is they're sending traffic, AKA people, to an offer to buy something, and that's it. The problem is your money is not made even on front-end sales. Your money is made on repeat customers. Like, a real business, a real thriving business, doesn't thrive on one-time sales. If we go back to President Obama, right, how he won the election and buried his competitors, he built an email list, a massive database of people that were interested in him, right, interested in him winning the election. He sent out a few emails and raised millions upon millions of campaign dollars and literally buried his competitors because they weren't using social media and they weren't building an email list, and he did. Any big business, I don't care if we're even talking Amazon, what does Amazon do? Once you go actually buy a product, right, they get your email. They have your contact information. Now they bring you back. They email you. I know Amazon literally spams the hell out of me probably 2, 3, 4, 5 times a week showing me different things that I might be interested in to bring me back to buy stuff. And it works quite a bit because I spend a lot of money on Amazon every single month. And that's the difference between people who make a lot of money in affiliate marketing and people who make very little. You know, most people will not buy right away. It may take 3 times, it may take 7 times, it may take 10 times, it may take even 20 times to introduce somebody to a product and reintroduce them to different ways of why they need that product before they decide to make a buying decision. I can't count how many thousands of dollars if I would have not been building an email list. I've literally had people get on my email list, not buy anything for like 6 months, a year, and then buy a $10,000 package page right out of the gate. That would have cost me a lot of money if I was just running people to a sales page and hoping that they're going to buy. This is what most amateur affiliates are doing. Most amateur affiliates, or I should say 99% of affiliates, are literally burning money. They're costing themselves lots of sales because all they're focused on is getting as many people to the sales page, and then only just a small percentage of those people buy. If you're building an authority website, if you're building an authority brand, a personal brand, if you collect people's emails, you give away something valuable for free to get them to trade their email, and you contact them quite consistently with not just spamming them with offers for sale, you're gonna make 100 times more money. I guarantee you, if you go watch other people's YouTube channels, the people that are really making tons of money, they're collecting emails. They're not just sending to a sales page. For every single person or every single example I give, there's gonna be an example of somebody that's still making lots of money doing it. But the example is here is that they can make 100 times more money if they would just collect emails, because now they can consistently get in touch with that person. Now, here's the other reason you want to build an email list. I love YouTube. I love Facebook. I think social media, hands down, is the future. Like, if you're not doing social media, you're probably not going to be able to compete in the future. With that being said, YouTube can literally delete your channel at any given time. If you follow anything about YouTube right now, there's a huge pandemonium of people like freaking out that built their business around AdSense. AdSense is basically the ads that pop up when you watch a video. A lot of channels, I think, like, I've heard a statistic of like 90% of channels are being wiped out, so they can't use AdSense anymore. So channels that built their whole brand, their whole business model around creating awesome content and just getting ad revenue, their business is literally done. Now, if you take it one step further, if YouTube just deemed like, hey, we don't like your channel anymore and we want to eliminate it, all those videos, all that content you put out there is done. Compared to if you built an email list, you still have consistent income month after month after month. You can always rebuild a social media channel. If Facebook decides to ban your Facebook ad account, if you ever do Facebook ads, you don't care, you got an email list. If YouTube terminates you, you don't care, you got an email list. If Instagram shuts you down because they think that you're doing something spammy for some reason, you don't care because you got an email list. The biggest, most profitable businesses online are building an email list. And when you switch to this method, hands down, it's going to change your life. I made my first $1 million with just 7,000 email subscribers. My coaching student, Steve Howe, which is in the real estate industry. Now, he's not an affiliate marketer. He actually sells his own products in the real estate industry. But he made over $350,000 off 2,000 email subscribers. So trust me, you do not need a very big email list. I know for some people, you know, 7,000 or 2,000 may sound like a lot of people. But honestly, if you were doing free traffic, you could build this in probably 3 to 4 months if you were busting your butt. Do the math. Is it worth making a ton of money? And the reason he made so much money off 2,000 subscribers is because he consistently follows up with them. He consistently delivers value to one specific group of people that are interested in what he's doing. And then when he presents a product, it's like, it's game over. He makes tons and tons of money. So I don't care what industry you decide to go in, whether it's in the make money online industry, whether it's in the fitness industry, whether it's in some kind of hobby niche. At the end of the day, even if you're selling Amazon products, you want to build an email list, because then you control the customer. You have the customer's follow-up information. So even if you recommend them to Amazon, you didn't just turn over the customer to Amazon. You still have their contact information. Now you can recommend more products. This is how you scale a big, big business. You don't just sell one thing. You sell two things, three things, four things, five things, and consistently keep serving the customers you already have. It's 10 times harder to keep getting new customers every single month compared to serving the customers you already have, the customers that already like you, the customers that already trust you, that you spent all that time building the relationship with. So if you take method number two, which is building an authority website and building a personal brand where people trust you, you combined it with building an email list, you literally have money on tap. It's the real definition of push button money. All right, so I want to wrap this video up, and I want to give you one final tip that's going to help fast track your results, and that's finding a mentor. Now, with that being said, there's going to be different levels of mentorship, right? There's going to be, you know, one-to-one coaching. There's going to be high-level masterminds, which is like what I'm joining this year. And at different levels of your career, right, you're going to be getting different types of mentors. When you first start out, probably realistically, you can't even afford one-to-one coaching. Usually that's when you're actually starting to make some decent money, or it's when you have a lot more money up front that you just want to get the answers right away, right? A course gives you their blueprint. One-to-one coaching gives you, you know, hand-holding. They actually can look at everything you're doing. They can critique what you're doing. You're basically paying for more of their personal time. A mastermind is where it's not just the coach. You're actually getting surrounded around himself or herself and all of their students, right? So everybody is working together, collaborating, sharing ideas. you know, I'm at the stage now where I'm going from like making, you know, over a seven-figure business to now doing seven figures in a year. So now I'm not really interested in one-to-one coaching anymore. I'm more interested in being in high-level masterminds where everybody in the room is making 10 times more money than me. So it makes me feel like I'm not really doing anything. What that's going to do is it's going to motivate me to work harder. I'm going to get to learn from other people in the group. We all get to share and collaborate on ideas. Plus, I also get to learn from the coach that I pick, right? But I realize not everybody has 30 grand, 50 grand to drop on something like that. At the beginning of your stages, you're going to be doing like what I did, where you first probably invest in courses. You know, if you don't even have the money to invest in courses, and at least buy the books, study all the videos of your mentor that you follow, and literally listen and watch everything they do. In fact, you can learn a ton by just watching what your coach does. Now, look, don't make the mistake of doing what I did, which is where most people get this thing they call information overwhelm. Is you follow like 10 people, if not more. You know, if you think about it, when you learned algebra in school, if you were in high school, did you get 10 algebra teachers? Hell no, you had one person you studied from and you learned from them, right? But when people go into internet marketing and they try to learn how to make money online, they literally pick all these different mentors. And what happens is one person's into Shopify, one person's into Amazon, one person's into Bitcoin, one person's into penny stocks, one person's into creating their own products, one person's into affiliate marketing, one person tells you to create 10 sites, one person says, put all your efforts in one website. And the point being is you become massively confused because you're following way too many people. So what you got to do is you got to pick a mentor. Now, the second thing you got to do is have faith in that mentor and listen to what they tell you to do. I want you to understand right now, when you get a mentor, their job is not to be responsible for your success. This is what most people do when they get a coach or they get a mentor. They think that coach or mentor is going to give them the secret. It is going to be responsible for their success. But at the end of the day, the only game changer is you. Like, you're the person responsible for your success. As I talked about at the very beginning of this video, you have to take responsibility for your own life. What I can tell you is you're going to have many different coaches. Like, that was my first coach. He literally did not coddle me like a baby. He didn't pat me on the back. He didn't tell me things were going to be easy. He literally forced me to become very uncomfortable and learn to get uncomfortable, or I should say he made me learn to get comfortable being uncomfortable. And so what I mean by this is when I first started, I didn't want to do videos. He made me do videos. I didn't want to do webinars. He made me do webinars before I even had a clue how to do a pitch or how to even set up a webinar. My very first webinar, I got on and talked about what I was doing with YouTube. And I said, all right, guys, thanks for coming. I'll see you later. And I literally got sales because people stopped me and said, wait, Zach, don't you have something to sell? Because they're used to getting on webinars and buying stuff, right? The first time I launched my first product, I didn't want to launch a product. He made me launch a product. Then he watched people inside of my Facebook group ask me consistently for coaching. I'm like, no, I don't have a coaching program. So what'd he do? He made me launch a coaching program. At every step of the way, I was very uncomfortable. And I'll be quite honest, I kind of fault him on every step of the way. But I decided that I was going to be coachable. I picked him as my mentor, so I listened to him. But even at a later stage, right, after I did thousands of videos, he's like, all right, it's time to do live streams. Oh man, I don't want to do live streams. But eventually I got over myself and I started doing live streams, and it literally got me to the point where I could do $50,000 on one live stream. But the difference was I was coachable. I was listening to him. I may have kind of let my ego get in the way at times where I'm like, oh, I don't want to do that. But I was willing to get over myself. I decided that at the end of the day, I picked him to be my mentor. I had faith in him. And I was coachable. And that's the biggest thing you got to understand. When you get a mentor, don't get 10 mentors, because if you're following all these people, you're going to be confused. And when you get a mentor, believe in them. Stop questioning them. Don't make the mistake that Zach did, where like every step of the way, you're like, nah, I don't want to do that. Just be willing to do what's necessary. At the end of the day, here's the thing. A coach or a mentor, because a mentor is really like somebody who guides you. A coach is somebody who's working with you one-to-one and they're helping you, you know, basically implement everything. Like, when you get a coach, you get a mentor, actually be willing to do exactly what they say. Because if you fight them, like, there's no point in even looking to them to help you. Like, most people want to do just what they want to do, and then they complain when they don't get the results. So here's an example. If you go buy a course, and then you go through the course, and then you only do like the steps that you want to do, you can't blame that person for not getting the results. And even if you do all the steps and it doesn't work as fast as it worked for them, you have to be responsible for your own results. You have to be willing to do more. You have to be willing to be consistent, because maybe, for example, for your mentor, it took them 6 months to make, I don't know, $1 million, and you've been doing it for 6 months and you've only made like like maybe $20,000, so you feel like something's wrong. At the end of the day, everybody's gonna have their own obstacles, their own challenges, their own things they have to overcome. But the most important thing that you can realize is that you are the one that's responsible for your results. So when you pick a mentor, take responsibility for your success, be willing to implement the steps that they teach you, and don't try to fight them, and don't try to follow like 10 different people, because it causes confusion, it causes you to prolong your success, and at the end of the day, if you try to do everything by yourself, it's gonna be tough. Now, final tip, if you don't have the money to, say, even buy a course, get books, listen to podcasts, listen to audios, or listen to every video they put out, whatever they have. If you don't have money, don't make an excuse. Remember what I said earlier, entrepreneurs are resourceful, so work with what you have. When I first started, I started with books. Then I started basically watching every YouTube video or listening to every podcast of the mentors that I was following at the time. When I had money, I bought $1,000 courses. Once I got over that point and I started making some money, I invested into higher level coaching. So at each step, work at where you're at, use the resources you have, and be willing to do what's necessary. That is my final tip. I hope you got value in this. I hope this helps you see how you can get started with affiliate marketing. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button, click the notification bell, so that way you get notified every single time I publish a video, and I will see you tomorrow.